is the latest weather forecast from Bowe Radio.
Cloudy with the odd teasing burst of sunshine has been the story of the day and continues that way tonight, but without the sunshine. But that's because it's dark. You don't get sunshine in the dark. Low 6 degrees. Mother Nature is confirming it's Monday tomorrow with rain all day and a high of 8 degrees across Sherwood.
Stop by for A Wee Natter with Jenny and Marc Steele on Bowe Radio.
Hey, it's A Wee Natter. I'm Marc Steele, and across the table from me is...
Jenny Steele.
And we are joining you on the week that we had National Name Yourself Day. Any ideas what you'd want to change your name to, dear listener, and you, Jenny, as well?
Well, this conversation brings me back to one I had with my mum when we were discussing why I was called Jenny, and she says she was going to call me Hazel but thought I might get bullied at school but people might call me Hazelnut, and then she also was going to call me Bridget but again thought I might get called Bridget the Midget.
Bridget the Midget?
Yeah.
How did you... I think your mum's got, you know, it's a tougher idea of what was in heads than the kids, school kids do, you know.
Yeah.
I'll be honest with you, my name, I'm not going to lie, sounds like what cheap cutlery's made of. Marc Steele. It's like not as good as stainless steel. It's going to leave marks on it. It's going to rust.
Yeah,
So it's Marc Steele. It's for knockoff cutlery, right?
Mm.
I've been thinking, right, if I was going to change my name, I'd go with something gender neutral, just to mess with people. So they don't know if I'm a guy or a girl. Or in between, or whatever it is nowadays, right?
Chris.
Yeah, so you go with something like Sam Steele.
No,
wait. The initials SS will get me into trouble with that one. And on that note, the postbag has arrived. And last week we were asking, what weird confession are you willing to make? And being in touch has been Sam Killip saying, my confession is that I was once at my friend's house, a mid-mouthful full of chocolate milkshake, and he made me burst out laughing. The rest is history and probably a lot of washing up, because chocolate milk doesn't come out of your shirt very easily, does it?
It doesn't. Nesquik.
I don't think we really worry about the brand. It's still going to be it's going to be stuck there no matter who ends up being, isn't it?
Sandra Owens now. Sandra says, once when she was a student nurse, she had to carry a lunch tray with a silver service into the room of a duchess.
Ooh.
Who was a private patient. And as she opened the door, she tipped the tray and the dish with the mashed potato. It went sliding onto the floor.
Oh.
She was very embarrassed and left... A boring life. Sorry, Sandra, that's just reminding me. I used to do a bit of silver service waitressing, just for a little bit of pin money in a hotel. And I was getting in between, as you do, is it serve from the left, clear from the right, and knocked a guy's wig off.
Really?
It's so funny. I couldn't stop laughing.
Was it somebody famous?
No, it wasn't. It was just like a rotary round table thing. And I just went and it just... toupee flying off.
That sounds like something out of Fawlty Towers, and you'd be watching a Fawlty Towers thinking,
yeah,
there's no way that could really happen. That's going
so
too
funny.
Far, isn't it? And also got Chris Curley saying, I caught up with a wee natter this afternoon and have to say I miss Jenny's voice chirping in. At least somebody did.
Can't think
of any confession, but I might add, on the subject of ring pool tins, because we declared in elected that the policy of the People's Manifesto is going to be every tin has to have ring pools.
Yes.
However, Chris has a complaint. Those tins of expensive cat food have ring pools.
Yes.
But they're pretty tough and I cut my fingers a few times pulling them.
I do that on my baked beans. I pull it and it comes like 3/4 of the way off. And then I either try and get the rest of it off and it cuts my finger or it splats bean juice all in my face.
Oh,
so
dear.
They're a bit of an issue as well.
Yeah, well, luckily an angel now prefers the cheap stuff in pouches. So maybe that's your solution. You just need to eat boil-in-the-bag food that's available in pouches. And we also got one more message from Vicky Fairweather that might scare you.
Oh.
Yeah, we'll find out what that's all about after the vamps. And can we dance? It's A Wee Natter on Bowe Radio and Thatcham Town Radio too.
I talk a lot of shit when I'm drinking. Can we dance?
The Vamps, Can We Dance? Which just reminds me of nightmares. Okay, that's a little unfair. Maybe the Vamps don't do that for me. With nightmares, they're different for all of us, aren't they?
Mm.
They're all a bit different. Sometimes it's just that the corner shop never has any Vimto. That'd be quite a nightmare, wouldn't it?
Sometimes it's when you eat the last of the chocolate.
I eat the last of chocolate.
All right, me then.
Other times, yes, indeed, it's a little more scary. Take this message from Vicky Fairweather saying, I dreamt about a wee natter the other night.
Oh, I feel a little bit honoured.
Yeah, it was weird. I told you not to feel honoured yet. As all good nightmares are, being weird, okay? Jenny and Marc were looking for somebody to present the show while they were away. Just to let you know, we are going to be away in May.
Yeah.
So this nightmare could come true.
How you feeling, Vicky?
How you feeling, Vicky? And a listener was randomly selected, and it was me. So I'm guessing it's a bit like the National Lottery with a big giant finger coming out the sky and saying, it could be you. And Vicky Fairweather, it is you, unfortunately. You have been selected to present a wee natter. And it just comes out of the sky and points at you. And you get no choice. You just got to do it. That's how we ended up in this gig in the first place. Just got randomly selected. Anyway, continuing on with Vicky's message, they went off without telling me what to do.
That sounds like us.
That does sound like us, to be honest with you. And I was scared to speak and hoping that the music would automatically play. I'll let you into a little radio secret, dear listener. That's exactly what we do as well. We just sit here hoping that the music will come in at some point.
Yeah.
And we just keep talking until the music appears. Yeah. So there she was, just a silent two-hour radio show, which probably got better ratings than we get on this. So it got me wondering, off the back of Vicky's message, what is your ultimate nightmare? Do you have an ultimate nightmare, Jenny?
I used to have nightmares that I was being eaten by crabs.
Eaten by...
Yeah, I don't know where they come from. All of a sudden, the room would be full of crabs.
You don't have an addiction to crab sticks, and it's like, oh my God, the amount of crab sticks I've eaten, and crabs might come after me. So it wasn't one of those things, then?
No, it wasn't that, no.
It wasn't a bit...
I don't know where it's come from.
Well, me, I have an irrational fear of birds, the little freaky dinosaur things. Although I've got to admit, a school trip to Martin Mere didn't help. There was a few ex-birds lying around. It ingrains a picture in your young mind. And it turns out our neighbours have now got chickens in a housing estate.
Oh, lovely. So have they got a cockerel? Bah, bah, bah,
bah, bah, every morning. And you'll get the cats going after them as well. So I assume it's going to be a lot of fun. And I suspect in the next few weeks will be me fighting them off in my nightmares. So I'm going to open this up to you, dear listener. What is your ultimate nightmare? What is the big scary thing that means that you cannot sleep at night? We want to hear about it. We want to share your nightmares and have absolutely no solutions because we're not that sort of people.
Yeah.
We can't fix your nightmares. But want to hear about them, get in touch on the phone 01623 888 730. Yeah, you can text 073 79 78 49 00, or you can email requests@bowradio.co.uk and tell us about all those things that freak you out at night. Usher, Kissing Strangers, and before that, Sweet Female Attitude and Flowers. There's a wee natter on Bowe Radio and Fatcham Town Radio too, where it turns out that apparently we're your worst nightmare.
Who said that?
It was that what was her name?
Oh, Vicky, Vicky. I thought you meant somebody else who just like texted in and went, it's you.
Yeah, they got in touch and we just saw this big lottery finger coming overhead going, it's you. You have been selected as the nightmare. No, we're not just asking about nightmares. We are doing good things as well, and we're going to put you in charge of the music in something we call covers versus originals.
We need a soundtrack for that.
I've got a Casio keyboard in my garage, I'm sure. And that's my challenge for next week, is to knock something up. But anyway, it is your chance to pick one of two songs. One of them's a cover, one of them's original. It's as simple as that. It's very much the Ron Seal of radio things. It does what it says in the tin.
Mm.
There's no complication involved. The two songs we're talking about this week, it's My Life.
It is.
Not that the songs are My Life, the song's called It's My Life. And your two options are Talk Talk or No Doubt. Which would you prefer to hear? Get in touch 01623 888 730, or you can text 073 79 78 49 00, or you can email requests@bowradio.co.uk and tell us which version of It's My Life do you want to hear on A Wee Natter. It turns out Jamiroquai is the space cowboy and Wee Natter from Bowe Radio and Fatcham Town Radio 2, where we're putting you in charge of music in something we call covers versus originals. And no, I haven't got the Casio keyboard out yet. I can only apologise for that. I will do it at some point. I will make us a little theme tune thingy me bob up, but I haven't got around to it yet. I can only apologize for that one. However, it is one of those covers versus originals where it's very much going in one direction. It's My Life, Talk Talk versus No Doubt.
See, which, Talk Talk's original.
Yes.
Yeah.
I thought everyone knew that.
I don't know. You never know these things, do you?
You never do. So there's still a chance for you to flip it. You could change the way it's going to go, or you can confirm the way it's going to go. Get in touch. 01623 888 730. Text 073 789 7849 00, or you can email requests at bowradio.co.uk and tell me which version of It's My Life is going to be playing, the cover or the original. Jocelyn Brown coming to the conclusion that you're somebody else's guy. It's A Wee Natter on Bow Radio and Faversham Town Radio 2.
Bow Radio would like to thank all our sponsors. We couldn't be here without you.
Indeed, we have to give special thanks to Property Drain Check Mansfield, Ollerton and Booton Town Council, Arnold Clark Cars, Edwinstowe Parish Council, Essential Site Skills Limited, Notts County Council, Walesby Parish Council, Worksop Freemasons, ABIB Motors Tuxford, and Sherwood Grange Care Centre as well. And on a slightly different note, we put you in charge of the music in something we're going to call covers versus originals. And you have been voting very much in one direction, a ratio of about 5-1.
Got another one in.
Which way is it going?
Ellie Merritt wants... Da-da.
She wants da-da?
Yeah.
What's da-da?
She wants the original.
She wants the original, yeah. Which makes it even stronger ratio. Which means that you've probably already figured out it is, of course... Talk Talk, It's My Life.
It's the best.
What will happen next week at Covers versus Originals is entirely down to you. But the only one thing I do know is there will be a Casio keyboard involved. We are going into the future. As chosen by you in Covers versus Originals, Talk Talk, It's My Life. Part of A Wee Natter on Bow Radio and Faversham Town Radio 2. But a little bit earlier, we were asking you about nightmares. And Ellie's come back with one saying, what I see in the mirror. That's the sort of nightmare that I have. Welcome to the club there, Ellie. And on a slightly different topic, is it just me, or do you sometimes read news articles, right? And realise that we are living in the sci-fi future?
Oh.
Yeah. I mean, you know, we still have old-fashioned stuff. You know, like diesel buses and, you know, we still have... I don't know, we have to go to the shops and pick up our food. You know, you still have to do old fashioned
things. Still have all that, analogue radios, that sort of thing.
Yeah. You know. But take this story that I found, right? It's bacteria that turns plastic into silk.
Really?
Apparently the process is a bit like brewing beer. Now, I don't know if that makes me want to drink plastic or never touch beer again. I'm not sure which way I'm going on that, but it did get me thinking, right? So I'm seeing all this happening, this sci-fi future. It's not everywhere. I totally get that. You know, some people still live in the past and still have coal fires and things like that. I get it, right? But it got me thinking, if we're in the sci-fi future, could we get bacteria that could turn BS into electricity? Oh, the world would be a better place. We'd have so much electricity going around. We wouldn't even get billed for it. You'd just get free of charge because you'd have so much, they'd have to get rid of it, wouldn't they?
Yeah.
We've gone very 80s, haven't we, with this one from Bronski Beat, Small Town Boy, and before that, Living in a Box with... Living in a Box. Yeah. There was a lot of creativity in the 80s. Anyway, it's A Wee Natter from Bow Radio and Faversham Town Radio 2. And the internet has informed me that Sandra has tipped us £10.
Wow.
I didn't even know it was a thing that we could do. I didn't realise we were busking. Does that mean I've got to get a little cap out and you've got to leave it there and I've got to play, you know, god-awful tunes on the bagpipes and things like that? Is that what we've got to do?
Oh, but no.
No, I've got to say thank you, Sandra. Yeah, we didn't ask for it.
Indeed.
And, you know, it is very much appreciated. We'll try not to blow it all on Findus Crispy Pancakes or treats for the cat. Although the cat is very persuasive.
She is.
She's a far better salesman than I am. I'm brilliant when it comes to sales pitches. I used to work for Comet. You remember with the bright orange shirts?
Yeah.
It's got to a point now where I've got kids working for me who are too young to know what Comet is.
Oh, wow.
That really made me feel dated when I was speaking to lads. Like, oh, yeah, I used to work in Curry's or whatever it was. I'm like, oh, yeah, I did that at Comet. And he just blank face. No idea. It's that long ago. But anyway, you know, that's the thing I was talking about there. Being a salesman, I wasn't very good. So when I was selling things at Comet, right, I'd do the sales pitch, go, oh, yeah, you want a washing machine. Oh, yeah, you want the Calgon stuff, even though we're in a part of the world where you don't get a limescale. but you really want Calgon. It'll like clean your machine or something like that. But anyway, I'd get to the end of it and they'd actually hand money over. I'm like, why did you buy it off of me? I'm confused here. What's going on? I would never expect a sale to actually go through. I am the world's worst salesman. So I somehow did quite well out there. But anyway, talking about going back to my teenage years, Jenny has been having a bit of fun with some teenagers. That's what happens in her world. We'll explain what it's all about after this one from Elton John. I guess that's why they call it the blues. John saying, I guess that's why they call it the blues. It's a wee natter on Bowe Radio and Thatcham Town Radio too, where a little bit earlier we were asking you about your worst nightmares, and Danielle Ferry's being in touch saying, my worst nightmare will be the feeling of being out of control in my life. I know what you're on about there, Daniela, because basically I just drift from thing to thing and it doesn't end well. But it's nice to feel like you're in control, isn't it?
It does, yeah.
And on a slightly different note, talking about not being in control, Jenny has been having some fun with some teenagers.
I have. I get a bus home from work. The bus is about 40-minute journey. On this occasion, it was a double-decker. So I go upstairs, on the back seat, there's teenagers, two girls, two boys. And you know when they have a conversation that is that bad, it's almost funny, and you're kind of laughing to yourself? I wanted to turn around and like, really? But yeah, it was quite bad. It's funny. Basically, they were trying to chat these two girls up, and one of the girls was like saying, the guy said to the girl, well, you know, do you get your nails done? How come you don't get your nails done? And she went, I've got no money, can't afford it. Well, okay, I pay for my bird to have her nails done once a month. And I thought, bird? How very 1970s, calling his girlfriend a bird.
Calling her a bird. It is. It's very old-fashioned, isn't
it? Old-fashioned.
It doesn't make me think of woman when I hear bird. I think, like, chickens and budgies and things like that.
And it was like she had a Yorkshire accent. And he says, I think your accent's absolutely gorgeous. And I think you're beautiful. Do all the birds in Sheffield look like you? And she was like, yeah. So me and my mate, we're going to live in Sheffield, aren't we? We're going to go there. And they were trying to, like, these are their words. Everybody was called bruv, and they were trying to get her to hit up. I think that's how you say it.
All right.
Their Instagram. And he was trying to do all these friend requests and stuff, and she was having none of it. And he was like, if you didn't have a boyfriend, would you go out with me? Do you think I'm good looking? Don't do me down, bruv. Don't do me down. And it was so like that. I thought, it's so bad. It was almost funny. And I thought, is this how the youth talk now? Everybody's bruv. Women are birds, and the blokes are paying for the birds to have the nails done once a month.
In all honesty, I have no idea, bloods, but I'll have a word with the fam. He's average white band, which I do know about. The perfect song to end any mixtape with. Average white band, let's go round again. Because you can then flip it over and play the mixtape again, can't you?
Yeah.
Although, when was the last time that A, you had a tape, and B, you had a mixtape, never mind a professional one?
Mm.
It wasn't yesterday, was it? Although, the weird thing is, tapes are kind of making a bit of a comeback at the moment. I think, you know, all the cool cutting-edge bands are starting to bring tapes back.
I mean, when I was a youth,
yeah,
or younger,
mm,
you got a mixtape done for you.
Oh.
From somebody that... Well, you know, from a friend, or maybe somebody that wanted to be a friend, they did you a mixtape.
That's because you were a woman.
What do they do now?
I didn't get mixtapes made for you. You got mixtapes made for you. I might have made the odd mixtape, and they were horrible, and I didn't give them to anybody because they were that bad and that embarrassing. You know, opening it with Spice Girls probably wasn't the best plan in the world. And on a slightly different note, we're going to bring the
heart to the people!
As part of something that we call Elected, we're going to put you in charge of all the weird and wonderful things that aren't being talked about by politicians today. But first, and right now, it's Electric Light Orchestra, Last Train to London, on A Wee Natter. As approved by Cheryl and Ellie, Electric Light Orchestra. Trip over your words with that one, don't you? Last Train to London, it's Wee Natter on Bowe Radio and Thatcham Town Radio too. And in case you've not noticed, it's an election year this year, and you will hear all sorts of promises in the build-up to the general election, but nobody will be dealing with the unimportant issues. There'll be all sorts of people making, oh yeah, this very important issue, this is how I'm going to solve it. This very unimportant issue, they're not even going to mention it. We want to change that. We want to bring the
power to the people!
That's part of something we call... And this week, we're tackling a big one. Ooh. It is customer services. I don't know about you, but ever since COVID, which is 4 years ago now, it's not yesterday COVID happened, 4 years ago,
please,
right?
Can I say it?
Yeah?
Your call is important to us. Please hold the line. It's not at all, is it?
No. Well, we know that because it was important. You would have answered it. The other one is due to an unexpectedly high number of calls, blah, blah, blah. Yeah. Absolute horse plop. I'm not going to lie about it. Companies have realised that you can pay very little, hire very few people, and we'll put up with it.
Mm.
And even worse, artificial intelligence, right?
Oh.
If you've got to deal with AI, you've got about zero chance with something that doesn't understand your problem actually fixing it. How's it going to solve the problem if it doesn't know what it's on about? It's just generating random words.
Mm.
It doesn't know what it's doing. You might as well have a dog on the end of the line if you're going to put AI in there. Or that wonderful message when you're on call, you're on hold for half an hour and you get that message every 30 seconds. Or you can go to our website and do blah, blah, blah. I've written and supported many website and services, right, over the years. I've actually made websites, I've supported them, I look after them and whatnot. So many of them are utter piles of junk.
Yeah.
And if it was available to do on your website, I would have done it.
Yes.
I wouldn't be messing around on the phone, on hold, listening to you every 10 seconds going, go to our website, because if your website wasn't rubbish, I would have done it on your website. Oh, Jesus. Or even worse, have you ever tried to cancel a service? You can sign up for it online. It takes 10 seconds. They take all your money. Brilliant. Why do we let them make it harder than signing up to terminate service?
I don't know.
Sign up online in 30 seconds, but you can't terminate that way? No, you've got to spend hours on the phone, or you've got to send a written letter to somewhere that doesn't actually pick up their post very often, you know, maybe every 6 months or something like that. So I've got two new policies for the People's Manifesto, right? One of them is that call centres have to pay enough to hire enough people so they can't use that nonsense about keeping on hold, you know, due to an unexpectedly high number. It can't be unexpected if it's happening every week, can it?
No.
It's utter nonsense.
True.
The penalty will be that the board of that company has to sit through a call queue that long to get their pay every month.
Yeah.
So it doesn't go into their bank account until they've sat on the phone for as long as we have to sit on the phone to get their pay. I think that's fair. I think they'll suddenly buck up their ideas if that was the case. And number two, it must be possible to cancel a service the same way and with as much ease that it was to sign up in the first place.
Yeah.
I think we've touched on some surprisingly important issues.
We are.
Considering this is all about unimportant issues, we've hit on some very important
ones. Important.
If you've got an unimportant issue, and that is the important bit, if you've got an unimportant issue that you think we need to tackle as part of the People's Manifesto and bringing the
power to the people,
then give us a call on 01623 888 730. You can text 073 79 78 49 00, or you can email requests at bowradio.co.uk and tell us about those unimportant things that, well, they're surprisingly important, aren't they? See, occasionally the Smiths do upbeat songs as well. They're not all wrist-slitty, aren't they?
I love the Smiths, I love a bit of Morrissey.
This charming man, and before that, David Grant and Jackie Graham. Could it be I'm Falling in Love? That's a very good question on A Wee Natter from Bowe Radio and Fatsham Town Radio as well, where that might be a question for us, but we have a question for you in what we're calling the Sunday Shonky Quiz. I haven't come up with a better name for it yet. And as promised, I will have to get the Casio keyboard out of the garage to make us a little theme tune for this.
Yeah, we need one for that as well.
Jane's just telling me I've got to make theme tunes for everything now.
Sing the theme tune, write the theme tune.
That is a joke. Weirdly, that's a joke that the kids won't get nowadays.
No,
cause, you know, that was Little Britain, wasn't it? And that's been off our tellies for, what, a decade now?
Yeah.
It's weird that these things stick around, isn't it? But yeah, the question we're asking tonight, and we'd love for you to work out the answer and tell us what it is. It's a nice, simple one. When did the Berlin Wall fall and, unfortunately, David Hasselhoff sing?
Oh.
There was a positive bit, there was a negative bit as well. So when did the Berlin Wall fall and, unfortunately, David Hasselhoff sing? If you can think you know the answer, do get in touch on the phone 01623 888 730, or you can text 073 79 78 49 00, or you can email requests at bowradio.co.uk. And while you're having a ponder and we're talking about requests, this one is for Cheryl Warner. It's a bit of Neil Diamond and Sweet Caroline on A Wee Natter. Electronic are getting away with it. It's a Wee Natter on Bowe Radio and Thatcham Town Radio too. And talking about, well, that's one of the Pet Shop Boys is in there, isn't it? It's not the complete Pet Shop Boys.
It's
but
Neil
one of
Tennant.
Them,
I get Neil Tennant and David Tennant mixed up. One of them's Doctor Who, isn't it?
Well, the day giveaway will be... I think we're going to see the Pet Shop Boys in June. Mm. And if you, you can't tell the difference when you go to see them live, we're in real trouble. Yeah. And talking about getting in touch, Sandra Owen's been in touch about customer services. I would stop all all the callbacks they used to do too. So you'd have to call people back.
Yeah,
if you've ever been in a call centre, you're sitting there going, why are you on about callbacks? No, it's when you actually had to phone somebody back from the call centre.
Yes.
Oh, I used to do outbound as well. Not sales, thankfully, but it was to do with accidents. So, you know, if you had an accident in a Tesco store, mm-hmm. they'd fill a form out and then it'd go into the call centre. We'd process them. And if it was for a member of staff and usually somebody that I knew working at a local store, I'd laugh at it and make a note of it on the computer. That's, if it was happening to a customer, it was I'd have to make the phone call, go, hello, I'm calling from Tesco, you know, heard you had a little accident in the store, and it was a wonderful one, I remember, and I thought, this is going to end up in the Daily Mail or something like that, because all it said was bitten by mouse.
Oh.
That's all it literally said on the accident report, bitten by mouse. I said, oh God, what's this going to be? So I ring them up, and I go, hello, I'm calling from Tesco, and so I hear you had an accident in one of our stores, all it says is bitten by mouse, can you give me a bit more details? I go, oh, it's my own stupid fault. I'm thinking, what? What did you get up to here? No, I saw them scurrying along and, you know, I'm a professional mouse handler. Should have known better. Went to grab them off the back of the shelf and got bitten in the process.
A professional mouse handler?
I did not even know that was a job.
And neither did I.
But talking of knowledge...
I just want to add something.
Uh-oh.
I've just had a little bit of a Facebook message from Daniela Ferry and saying that she was sipping on Wolfberry tea whilst listening to The Smiths. I want to know what Wolfberry tea is, Daniela.
I know what a wolf is.
Do I need some in my life?
I know what a berry is and I know what tea is, but I can't combine the three in my mind. I assume wolfberry is a type of berry.
Yeah.
And it's not wolves and berries that you mix together in a pot of tea. That would be something very, very, very and we were testing your intelligence, dear listener.
Yes.
We were asking about when David Hasselhoff was standing on a wall that was being knocked down, there was a bit more going on there as well.
Yes.
And we're asking when that was happening. It turns out a whole load of you are getting the right answer.
Really? Yeah, it must be a really easy one tonight. Cheryl, Ellie and Stephen Hall have all got the right answer.
I would do the ding-a-ding bit, but I'm pressing a whole bunch of buttons.
Oh, no.
Also,
shall I say that again?
Yeah, go on, give it another shot.
Well, here we go. So it's an easy one tonight, Marc. Are we rolling?
Hey. Yeah, you got that bit right.
I just want to add a little bit more that Stephen told me. He said that he was studying the history of 20th century Germany at the time, and his lecturer said, we're not just talking about it, we're living it.
Oh, that's very accurate, isn't it? I remember that one about 9/11. Because I think I was in school at the time, from what I remember. And it's not something that was directly affecting me, but it just, the whole world came to a stop, and it was that whole, did they really do that thing? And we watched it on the news. We didn't learn anything in school that day. I don't know why I'm laughing at 9/11.
No.
I shouldn't be laughing at it. It's very, very serious, very horrible way. But yeah, Maureen Stock got in touch with the correct answer. Also in touch with the correct answer is Sandra Owens and Henk as well, who also happens to mention that Looking for Freedom is the song that David Hasselhoff sung.
We haven't got that one. Hey!
I wasn't celebrating the fact we don't have that song. I was celebrating the fact he was telling us the correct song. But what we do have is another request for Henk. He's asked for, well, it always reminds me of Milton Keynes because that's where the video's filmed. That's the only fact I know about this song. It's Cliff Richard and Wired for Sound on A Wee Natter. Cliff Richard claiming he's wired for sound like he's some sort of radio station or something like that. It's A Wee Natter from Bowe Radio and Thatcham Town Radio too. We've got a couple of things going on. One of them is that Henk and Sandra are having a wee chat on Mixcloud. So if you watch us on there, which watching a radio show sounds a bit weird, doesn't it? We're doing radio with pictures. It's like nobody's ever come up with it before. But Henk was saying it was one of the first videos, so they did a song that we just played here, one of the first videos to use the Walkman, the small tape recorders that you carry, or tape players that you carry around with you. And the funny thing about them is I always got the cheap ones. I never got the fancy Sony ones or anything.
No, I didn't.
I got like the Alba specials from Argos.
Yeah.
And they were wonderfully rubbish because when the batteries were... How fast the tape played depended on how alive the batteries were.
Yeah.
So when you first played it, it played at normal speed, but as the batteries ran down, it got slower and slower and slower and quieter as well.
Yeah. There's only about 6 of them as well, and it costs a fortune.
And then my very first MP3 player was a USB thing that plugged in. It took batteries as well, and it only stored about 3 or 4 songs on it. But it's still fantastic. We're all going back in time a bit here. And talking about going back in time, we're asking you a wonderful question about when the Berlin Wall fell, and David Hasselhoff had a little sing on top of it as well. And we've had a couple more answers, haven't we?
Well, I said that Ellie Mary had guessed the correct answer, but she did say that she knew this as her friend John brought back pieces of the Berlin Wall after working there.
All right, I'm guessing military if he was out there.
I bet, possibly.
Because, well...
Not sure.
You could still go there if you weren't military, but...
Yeah.
Generally, most people I've spoken to that have been out there at that time, it was for military reasons. So the answer was, of course, 1989, which everyone that got in touch... So if you got in touch, dear listener, you got the answer correct. So you get a little celebratory... Just enjoy yourself then.
Bowe Radio would like to thank all our sponsors. We couldn't be here without you.
Indeed, we have to give a special thanks to Property Drain Check Mansfield, Ollerton and Booton Town Council, Arnold Clark Cars, Edmundstone Parish Council, I don't know why I'm laughing at that, Essential Skite Skills Limited, Notts County Council, Walesby Parish Council, Worksop Freemasons, ABIB Motors Tuxford, and Sherwood Grange Care Centre as well. And on a slightly different note, I've got two other things going on. One of them is that Stephen has been in touch through the Fashion Radio lines, and he wants to give a shout out to Paula. So I've given you your shout out, and I've also been a bit naughty as well.
Oh, what are you doing?
Yeah, I'll explain what it's all about, and hopefully not get myself in front of a judge after this one from Fiction Factory. Jenny may have asked, and I may be substituting names here. I'll leave it up to you to decide, dear listener. Is that guy from Umin League in this one?
I got the wrong band. I was thinking of something else. Who was I thinking of?
You were thinking of Phil Oakey.
Yeah, but what band was he in? Electronic? No.
No, he wasn't. No. He did some solo stuff.
He did, didn't
but he? He was mainly in Human League.
He was in the Human League, but he did the Together in Electric Dreams.
That was a solo piece done with Giorgio Moroder.
That's the one.
Who does all the film scores in the 1980s, not 90s. Anyways, A Wee Natter on Bowe Radio and Faction Town Radio 2, where it turns out we are experts in music.
I am, I don't know about you.
And I've got to ask, did you ever do anything naughty at school?
Yeah, I used to eat. I used to talk too much, keep getting chucked out of the classroom for talking too much.
I never got chucked out for that, but I did get into a few fights. I will stress I never started them. Mm-hmm. I also got accused of a few things I never did, although a teacher claiming, oh, Marc would never hurt a fly, didn't exactly help my reputation at school. It didn't go down. But there is a reason I asked, because there's this kid in the US. Mm. And if we're talking about the US, we've got to get ourselves in the mood for it, haven't we? Yeah. So let's play the little clip. Is both the sound of Murica and the sound of me not getting through customs when we go over there for our holidays.
Ooh, don't say that. That's frightening me now.
I'll get kicked back on the plane back to the UK. And funny thing is, we're doing sort of interactive chat thing here, and Henk is saying he picked the lunch to a teacher once. So I'm guessing, was it through the lunch or stole the lunch?
Did you steal it, Henk?
Lunch and teachers going on. So it turns out we were all a bit bad, DS, and that's what's going on. And anyway, this thing in the US, a kid sent a fax claiming to be the principal, which if you've never heard of a principal before, it's the head teacher of a school, right? Mm. He sent this fax claiming that the head teacher was resigning.
Oh.
So there's two mistakes going on there from this kid. One, he put his own phone number on the fax. And two, who uses a fax in 2024? Seriously.
Exactly, yeah.
At least when I faked emails from the head teacher, at least it came from his email address. Wait, was I supposed to confess that bit? Ah, well, who's going to arrest me 20-odd years later? It's never going to happen. Or is it? What are the rules on the...
I don't know. I'm going to have a look.
I'm going to go read the computer misuse site. Well, you enjoy this one from Midnight Star. It's Midas Touch on A Wee Natter from Bowe Radio and Fashion Town Radio 2. When's the last time you heard that one? It wasn't yesterday, was it?
It was on Solid Classics.
Midas Touch by Midnight Star. And it's on A Wee Natter from Bowe Radio on Faction Town Radio 2, where we might be getting ourselves into trouble. Turns out we were all just naughty.
Yeah.
So I was doing all sorts of naughty things with computers. It turns out Jenny was doing all sorts of naughty things that got her kicked out of the classroom. And Henk was stealing the teacher's lunch and got sent to the headmaster for it and was very upset because, you know, get sent to the headmaster for effectively nothing there, eh? And also Vicky Fairweather saying she hid under a table to get out of PE in primary school.
The thing is, once you get sent out of class for talking, even when it's not you, you always get the blame for talking because you've got that reputation as a talker. So the teacher would just pick on you straight away. And even when then when you said it wasn't me, you get done for back chat.
And then when it comes to the report card at the end of the year and they've got the teacher explaining, you know, what Jenny was like, it's always something like enthusiastic and makes friends easily.
Yeah.
And, you know, there was wording to explain that you were a chat rogue.
Yeah, yeah.
I can't remember exact wording now because it's been so long since I've read a report card. And I, considering I just went back to university a couple of years ago, that's not a good thing. Bit of Mike Posner and Cooler Than Me. It's Wee Natter on Bowe Radio and Fortune Town Radio 2. Well, Jenny's got something to share with us.
Well, I actually have, Marc. I want to talk about localisms, Marc.
Localisms?
Yes.
All right.
Well, yeah.
What do you mean by localisms?
So, have you got a word for something that you would call it, but somebody else would call it something different or not know what you're talking about?
Oh, this is going to be that bread roll thing, isn't it?
No, it's not like it. Oh, I just get a bit fed up. Is it the cob? Is it the bap? Is it the... No, nobody cares.
Nobody cares.
This is... I think you would probably know it as an off-licence.
Right.
From Nottingham, or maybe it was just from the area I was brought up in, we call it a beer off.
A beer off?
And when I moved down on the South Coast for the first time, somebody actually thought I was swearing at him because I said, oh, where's the nearest beer off? And it's like, what the hell's a beer off? And it's an off-licence, you know, where you can get, like, drinks, sweets or whatever, Chris from. And they didn't have a clue what I was talking about. And I just got to think, that's localism, isn't it? Is there anything that where you were brought up that you would call that we wouldn't have a clue what you were talking about?
I'll be honest with you, right? The moment I heard you talking about offies and corner shops and things like that, I was a little worried we were going to stray into the territory of phrases that we shouldn't have heard since the 1970s.
Yeah.
No, there were things I've heard it called that we should never be repeated in polite company.
No.
Quite frankly, it was disgusting even at that point. But if you're going to talk about localisms, one of the great ones from Scotland is going for your messages.
Oh.
Which means going to get your groceries, going to get your shopping.
Going for your messages.
Going for your messages. It's a wonderfully Scottish thing. It doesn't make any sense when you think about it.
It doesn't, do it? Sorry out there.
And another one, you know, Sandra Owens is joining in the conversation.
Excellent.
Here online saying, we call plimsolls daps in my neck of the woods.
I've never heard that, you see.
I've heard of dabbing, which is that sort of dance thing where you go like that.
Oh, I've heard of dobbers. That's not the same, is it? Oh, no, dabbing, where you dab a stain off or a mark off.
Yeah, well, apparently they're called daps, the plimsolls.
Daps?
They were just called plimsolls in my world.
In mine were plimsolls. And the other thing I just wanted to have a quick chat about is a lot of our listeners obviously follow Sutty, the Solid Radio Cat. We had a bit of a glitch on Facebook this morning. I don't know what was going on. Henk, if you're out there, if you're still listening, all I did was click on your link for a Sambuca plant and that's it. I was taken down, man. I don't know what was going on, but I'm back. We're back again.
And talking about glitches, apparently Vicky's also saying there's loads of these sort of phrases in Norfolk. Could you guess what a Bishy Barnaby is?
Sounds great.
Do you know what it is?
Go on, tell me.
Apparently it's a ladybird.
I
think you're pulling my leg.
Wow, Vicky, are you telling the truth?
Yes. And talking about things we can't quite believe, Nottinghamshire's least political radio show, this fine show, A Wee Natter, we have got what we call mayoral elections coming up, because we're getting an East Midlands mayor. And I sent a little email out to all the candidates, and one of them has got in touch and will be joining us on the show in a couple of weeks' time. It is Ben Bradley. I'm still poking the other ones, but he's the only one I can announce that's definitely coming on. So if you've got any questions for him, do get in touch.
Yeah.
But for right now, it's Tears for Fears and Pale Shelter. So we may have mentioned that I'll be interviewing Ben Bradley. passing your questions on to the man himself.
Mm-hmm.
I've got his phone number, got to give him a ring, see what he says. Mm. But it turns out I'm not the only person doing interviews. Hank has been in touch saying, nice guys from Tears from Fears. He interviewed them in Holland when he's working for National Dutch Radio in 1982.
Oh, wow.
So going back a little bit of time, Roland Orsball and Kurt Smith in 1985. They're the ones with Everyone Wants to Rule the World.
Excellent.
There you go. We didn't realise we had radio royalty with us.
We have. It's our Hank. talking about localisms again.
Yes.
Cheryl Warner said, yeah, we call Lady Birds Bishy Barnies for sure, but it's Bishy Barnabies really. And when you see the yellow dandelion and seeds, we call them Billy Bofters. I think that's really funny. And well, also, Stephen West been in touch to say, if you're from Grimsby and you're in a bad mood, you're generally known as miserable, you're known as being Mardy. Well, that's Nottingham as well, because you're also known as being Mardy. And also, you know when you're trying to put a brush through your hair,
yeah,
and you brush it tangled, we call them lugs.
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 Well, I think of ears when I hear lugs. I feel like it's cheating being Scottish on, you know, we're talking about localisms and things like that. Because I could go full Doric, you know, like my granddad used to do.
Yeah, you're cheating.
Yeah, it'd be like, even fit like, what you like, how are you? And, you know, you always call people quine and hen and things like that. So it feels like cheating being Scottish in this one. And also, as Sandra Owen's saying, isn't Sambuca a drink?
Have I said it wrong? Sambuca. There is a plant. It's got dark purple leaves and a nice purple flower. I managed to find one today at a garden centre.
Well, I believe the important bit is that you don't drink the
plant.
When you talk about the water, boys, this isn't the obvious one, is it? Fisherman's Blues is a wee matter on Bowe Radio and Faction Town Radio 2. Unfortunately, all good things must come to an end, and this is one of them. So we're going to leave you with Dilimitri and Roll to Me, and we'll catch you same time next week. How does that sound?
Great.